So SMA stands for spinal muscular atrophy, not SMA milk, which some people have heard of. And it's a genetic, that's an inherited neuromuscular disease, which particularly affects children. It's basically the motor neurons running down your spine get affected, and they control the messages that go to the muscles around your spine, so that it then causes those muscles to waste away. So it affects walking, arm movements, breathing, swallowing, anything that you can think of that comes from the muscles going down your spine. And it is a progressive disease. And it is, although not particularly well known, extraordinarily, it is the number one genetic killer of babies and infants. It's a really nasty condition that can have devastating effects. The SMA Trust is we're a medical research charity. So we are funding research into trying to find a cure and treatments for SMA. For some families, I think that they see that as the most important thing. If they've got a child that's affected, clearly they want something to help their child. And if they've sadly lost a child to spinal muscular atrophy, although they know that research isn't going to be able to help their own child, they're very keen to do something to make sure that other families don't have to go through what they've gone through. The main goal is obviously to help to find a cure. I mean, that's absolutely the ultimate ambition. What we're really trying to do is to give families some hope that there is a better future for people with SMA. But actually, the progress that's being made at the moment is phenomenal. SMA affects families in different ways. I mean, it really depends on the type of SMA that they have. So, for example, type 1, which is the most severe, little babies are diagnosed very early on, and it's very unusual for them to live beyond the age of sort of 18 months to 2, and they're never able to sit up or feed properly. They often require assistance with breathing. So clearly, that's a very difficult scenario for a family, because almost from the word go, they know that their baby has a very short life expectancy, and that brings with it, you know, huge emotional as well as physical challenges to deal with.
I started fundraising for the SMA Trust because we lost our daughter 2 Septembers ago to SMA type 1. Come on, skinny love, just last the year. We hadn't heard about the disease at all, and it was obviously new to us, and we decided that we wanted to put all our efforts into trying to help find a cure. And ultimate goal was to find a cure, but that in the meantime, finding ways of helping people to live with SMA if they had the later types, then that was our aim, really.
Fundraising for the SMA Trust for me means trying to help families deal with this terrible illness.
Very lucky, because we had lots of help locally. A children's community nurse and the doctors at the hospital here were brilliant, so they actually helped us to find ways to look after Lily in our home. So it actually didn't affect our life as much as home life as much as it may have done without all that support network. But it was obviously difficult with another child, giving him still the time he needed, being only 3 at the time, but still giving Lily all the extra support that she needed as well. So it was a tricky time, but we had lots of help.
Having lived through seeing our granddaughter suffer through this, really, the sooner we find a cure or something to alleviate the symptoms will be a good thing.
When Lily B was diagnosed with it, we hadn't even heard of it before, and so we looked on the internet, as one does these days, and read up about SMA and the SMA Trust.
It means everything, really, just to know that we are helping to find that, ultimately, the cure, but in the meantime to try and raise awareness. Lots of people that we meet have never heard of SMA, and our desire is for people to know about it and want to fundraise for it. It's such a devastating disease that it deserves a higher profile.
SMA research has gained huge momentum over the last few years, not just because of potential treatments in clinical trials today, but also because of the huge advances that they have made in understanding the disease since the discovery of the gene in 1995. This understanding is very important as it can lead to the discovery of new targets for treatments. We're also very proud of the work we're doing to help establish clinical trials both in the UK and the rest of Europe. In fact, we are already funding a major two-year project called SMA Reach UK in partnership with Great Ormond Street, which will lay the foundations needed to establish clinical trials in the UK.
Well, we organise one of our own events every year, which is called the Cotswold Way Mad Challenge, and it's a 50-mile through-the-night walk. We do it in June every year. It's our third one this year. We have teams which we name after the child. So, for instance, Team Lily B are in Essex, and they get all their friends and family in Essex doing various things, selling things, doing runs, doing charity events, coffee mornings, anything really. So we like the teams because they little hubs all over the UK will be doing fundraising activities for us, plus raising awareness of the illness, which is a big plus for us. The Mad Challenge was set up in 2010, and it was set up with our five at the time children who were teams. So it's Team Millie, Team Freddie, Team Marnie, Team Octavia and Team Benny. So they were the founder members of our Mad Challenge, and they all have SMA, and they all set their friends and family a Mad Challenge. And Benny did the original Athens Marathon, I believe, again in wheelchair but with friends and family. So that was a big campaign over a year, and it raised over £1 million. Well, because we're a small charity, we rely on outside help, so either volunteers or fundraisers. People have never heard of it, and the amount of people that come to us fresh that say, never heard of SMA, thought it was baby milk. And then they go out there, they start telling people about it, and then the word gets spread. By raising awareness of the trust and raising awareness of the illness, it means that we get even more money for research. And research is fantastic, because without research we won't be any closer to finding a cure. Text SMAT01 270070, up to £10. So shine bright.